Can't we go back to class?
You could take a real simple beat, you know, and if you can lock in with, say, a bass player or a guitar player, and make a horn player or a piano player climb up the wall. You know what I'm talking about?
You got to have some guys for some soul music that know what it's all about, that know something about soul. Soul and funk. You got to have some guys that know this stuff. More than likely, get on with it.
Funk brothers, we play together every day, and most of them play together every night. So I knew what kind of pickups the drummer was going to use. Bop, 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 bop. That was just a standard that was in Motown.
Everybody had a pocket back then. They had been doing this. Their experience was so vast that they just did things effortlessly. I always said the musicians at Motown took rock and roll and smoothed it out a little bit, you know, with a jazz flavor to it.
All those guys play jazz. Music appreciation made me start there to appreciate music. I like all kinds of music.
The 12-piece rhythm section in Studio A, we had our own feel, but essentially every record that came out of Motown, that record that brought it to life was that rhythm section, the Funk Brothers. That's what we did.
You can listen to a track and you can differentiate between whether that was Benny Benjamin or Uriel Jones or Pistol Allen. Yeah.
Sometimes a feel is just nothing. It'll be larger, nothing played, or just one kick note will be fatter than filling it all up with a whole bunch of chops musically.
You catch a drummer that can really stay in a groove and push a horn player. A musician will work a whole lot more than a drummer that loves the solo all the time. Some of them call it old school.
Hey, funk, man. Funk and soul.
But you can't put the feel on paper.
Soul music? That's from the heart. That's from the heart, man. Because we all have a soul.
We had a thing going on, man, with that group, man. It was unbelievable.
We were all friends. We hung out after the gig, and I just think we made great music, but we got very good at it because we did it here.
We were hot. Man, we were hot.
In the clubs, the studio, we was humping, working out, you know.
And our job was to read the charts correctly, add something extra to it, and make it a hit record.
And it was a pocket. I mean, when you play it live with Uriel, it felt like you were in the studio.
And then, you know, you have to love what you're doing. And to me, I express myself better through my music than I do when I speak.
Well, look now, you know, if you think of some more stuff, you know, just feel free to call me, man. All right, you too. Bye-bye.